Letter O. Letter U.
7 years ago, Tony Nicklinson was a healthy 51-year-old man.
He's the life and soul of the party. He's a big bloke, ex-rugby player. He worked hard, but he played hard. He was, you know, full of life, great sense of humour. Loved the sound of his own voice. Hot, aren't you?
Then he suffered a stroke. Today, the man who loved life is fighting for the right to end it.
My name is Tony Nicklinson and I have locked-in syndrome. This means that most of my body is paralysed, but my mind is as it was before the stroke. All I can move is my head, and the stroke took away my power of speech. Now I talk to people with a perspex spelling board or a computer operated by my eye blinks. My day typically begins at 5 a.m. I need only 4 or 5 hours sleep because I lead a very sedentary life. I watch television until 8:30 when the first of the carers come. During this time, my wife checks on me at 7:30, and between then and 8 o'clock, she gives me my drugs and juice for breakfast. These drugs are only to make my life more comfortable, as I have refused all drugs that are designed to prolong my life since 2007. Unfortunately for me, tomorrow will be exactly the same, and the next, ad infinitum until the day I die.
If you were given the right to make that decision, would you choose to do so?
Yes.
But under British law, Tony doesn't have that right. He's physically incapable of committing suicide, and it's illegal for anyone to help him. At present, so-called voluntary active euthanasia, when assistance is required to end a life, constitutes murder, and the sentence is life imprisonment. Tony has taken his case to the High Court in Britain, saying he's not looking for a new law allowing euthanasia. He simply wants a remedy to the current legislation, which he calls discriminatory.
Some people have in the past spoken to me in the loud, slow and deliberate tones normally reserved for the deaf or daft. I am neither. All too often well-meaning, able-bodied people just assume that if a person is so severely disabled that he needs assistance to commit suicide, he must automatically be unable to deal with such a choice. I say that where a person has the mental ability, he should have the choice of his own life or death. The only difference between you and me is my inability to take my own life without assistance.
Tony's condition hasn't changed for 7 years, and he and his wife say the longer the court takes to rule on his appeal, the longer his only hope for relief is postponed.
I think the injustice of it all, you or I can go out and take our lives at any time we want, whereas Tony, being the one that really needs that right, can't do this, and he's only asking for what everyone else has got, really, to, you know, his right to take his own life. He wants that giving back to him.
The High Court is expected to issue its judgment in Tony's case after the end of July. As difficult as things are for them, Jane says she and Tony have never had any doubts that assisted suicide is the right choice for them.
It's taken so long to get to this point, and he's never ever wavered, and it's what he wants, it's what he wants desperately. So if it's what he wants, it's what we want.